बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द बायोलॉजी लेसन। विश यू ऑल अ ब्लेस्ड रमदान। स्टे होम एंड कीप योर इम्यूनिटी स्ट्रॉन्ग बाय ईटिंग हाइजेनिक एंड हेल्दी होम मेड फूड एट सहर एंड इफ्तार। रिमेंबर दैट अ स्ट्रॉन्ग इम्यूनिटी कैन कीप यू सेफ फ्रॉम द वायरस एंड प्रोटेक्ट यू। लेट्स स्टार्ट द लेसन फॉर वीक नंबर 5। We are doing chapter 3, biodiversity, and the topic for today's lesson is conservation of biodiversity. The objectives for today's lesson are, by the end of the lesson, students will be able to define the key terms, discuss the importance of conserving biodiversity, enlist endangered and extinct species in Pakistan, describe impact of human beings on biodiversity, explain the causes and effects of deforestation, and list down different steps for conserving biodiversity in Pakistan. Before we start today's lesson, a quick recap of the previous lesson. We did the 5-kingdom classification system, which was introduced by Whittaker, and he classified all organisms into 5 kingdoms: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. Then we discussed the status of viruses, and we saw that viruses, as they are acellular particles, so they were not placed in any of the 5 kingdoms. After that, we did binomial nomenclature, which is a scientific method of giving names to all the living organisms, and every name of an organism consists of 2 parts. The key terms used in this lesson are endangered. A species is called endangered when it is at risk of extinction in near future. Extinct. In an ecosystem, a species is called extinct when there is no doubt that the last individual of that species has died in that ecosystem. Habitat. Area of the environment in which an organism lives. Deforestation. Deforestation means cutting down of trees for the conversion of a forest to non-forest land. Conservation, it is a careful preservation and protection of something. Now the question is, why is biodiversity important? All species are interconnected. They depend on one another. With less biodiversity, these connections weaken and sometimes break, harming all the species in the ecosystem. Biodiversity is important to people in many ways. As biodiversity decreases, these systems break down. During the last century, great loss of biodiversity has been observed. Causes: human actions. Human actions have threatened species and ecosystems. Species extinction harms the stability of ecosystem. Biologists warn that if biodiversity continues to be reduced at the same rate, global ecosystem would collapse. Now, due to human activities, many plant and animal species have also gone extinct in Pakistan. The image below shows different animals that have vanished from their wildlife habitats in Pakistan. Now let's see the impact of human beings on biodiversity. Advancement in agriculture and industry has resulted in growth in human population. To improve the living conditions for 700 million humans living on Earth today, we are imposing serious threats to the survival of biodiversity. Major causes of species extinction are habitat loss, deforestation, overhunting, introduction or removal of species, pollution, and climatic change. The pie chart shows the percentage of impact of different human activities on biodiversity. Now, here are the examples to show that how the introduction or removal of species can threaten the life of other organisms in that area. So eucalyptus plants, they were imported from Australia and they were introduced in Pakistan. These plants consume more water and have disturbed the water table level of underground water in that area. It harms other small plants that grow near eucalyptus trees. The other example is of sea star. Sea star starfish eats mussels. Mussels are small shelled organisms, animals. If sea stars are removed from a region in ocean, mussels rapidly increase in number. So large number of mussels, they prey on small animals and they become dangerous for their existence. So this shows how the removal of sea star can affect the life of other small animals living in that area. Deforestation. Deforestation means cutting down of trees for the conversion of a forest to non-forest land. Deforestation is one of the major causes of species extinction. The destruction of significant areas of forest has resulted in a degraded environment pollution with reduced biodiversity due to habitat loss. Let's discuss some causes of deforestation. Why do humans clear forest lands? Trees are cut down for many reasons, including to be used, sold, or exported as timber, wood, or fuel, charcoal. This is called logging. To be used for farming purposes, grazing fields for livestock, or large-scale farming activities. To make room for human settlements and urbanization, these include making space for shelter, industries, and roads, and to make room for mining. Now let's see what are the effects of deforestation. Major effects are global warming, soil erosion destruction, water cycle disturbance, loss of biodiversity, and climatic change. Trees play a critical role in absorbing greenhouse gases that fuel global warming. Fewer forests mean large amounts of greenhouse gases entering the atmosphere. Without trees, the soil is free to wash or blow away, which can lead to vegetation growth problems. Trees help to control the level of water in atmosphere by helping to regulate water cycle, but due to deforestation, there is less water in the air to be returned to the soil. This causes drier soil in inability to grow crops. Effects of deforestation include soil erosion, coastal flooding, and destruction of homelands. Deforestation can have a negative impact on the environment. The most dramatic impact is a loss of habitat for millions of species. It also increases hunger and poverty. Let's study some of these effects in detail. Global warming. 20% of global carbon dioxide emissions are caused by deforestation as there are no trees to remove the carbon dioxide for making their food. Trees, they cool the atmosphere and store greenhouse gases. Loss of natural resources, flooding and soil erosion result from deforestation, and as a result of that, soil fertility is lost. Food insecurity, 1.6 billion people living in poverty depend on forest for their food, fuel, and livelihoods. Loss of biodiversity. Forests are home to over 70% of animals, plants, and other organisms. Billions of pollinator bees, they have lost their habitat. Human encroachment and logging destroys forest. So 30 million acres of forest, they are lost every year. Overhunting. Overhunting has been a significant cause of the extinction of hundreds of species and the endangerment of many more, such as whales, ibex, urial, marhor, the national animal of Pakistan, etc. Commercial hunting, both legal and illegal, is the principal threat. Steps for the conservation of biodiversity. Though rich in biodiversity, Pakistan today faces severe threats to its animal and plant species. The greatest concern is the loss of natural habitats. Main causes of this loss are rapid growth in human population, prevailing poverty in rural areas of Pakistan, low literacy rate. The International Union for the Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, IUCN, and the World Wildlife Fund Pakistan, WWFP, work in close coordination with Pakistan's Ministry of Environment and other government and non-government organizations to solve this problem. The IUCN has prepared the first national red list, the list of endangered or threatened species. Environmental work that has been carried out in Pakistan in order to conserve species and associated habitats. Number 1. National Conservation Strategy. In 1980s, IUCN and the Government of Pakistan formulated the National Conservation Strategy for Pakistan for the conservation of Pakistan's biodiversity. Number 2. UN Convention on Combating Desertification, CCD. This is an international treaty against damage and poverty in dry lands. Pakistan signed this in 1997. Number 3. Himalayan Jungle Project, HJP. It started in 1991 in the Palas Valley in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. It aimed at protecting one of the richest areas of biodiversity in Pakistan. Number 4. Conservation of Biodiversity of the Suleiman Range, Balochistan. Suleiman Range Chilgoza Forest is the largest Chilgoza forest in the world. In 1992, the WWF Pakistan started its conservation program. Number 5. Northern Areas Conservation Project. The northern areas of Pakistan serve as a habitat for a number of wildlife species. The survival of these species is under threat. The NACP is a project of WWF Pakistan which is successful in implementing a ban on the hunting of these species. Number 6. Conservation of Migratory Birds in Chitral, KP. Chitral lies on the migratory route of several important bird species. These birds face enormous hunting pressure. WWF Pakistan initiated efforts to reduce the hunting pressure in 1992. The efforts proved successful. It is estimated that about 200,000 of the 1 million migratory birds passing through Chitral are killed during migration. Number 7. Conservation of Chiltan Marhor. Hazar Ganji National Park is located close to Quetta and is the only remaining habitat of Chiltan Marhor in the country. WWF Pakistan developed the management plan of the park. Number 8. Ban on games. Foreigners visit the northern areas and play many games in which bears are used. WWF Pakistan has been successful in imposing a ban on this illegal practice. Endangered species in Pakistan. 3 endangered species have been discussed in your book. The first one is Indus dolphin. According to WWF, only 600 animals of the species of Indus dolphin are left today in the Indus River. It is also known as blind Indus dolphin. And it is also found in the tributaries of Indus River in Satluj, Ravi, Chenab and Jhelum. It lives in fresh water and lives for approximately 28 years. The population of this species declined due to water pollution, poaching. Poaching means illegal hunting or catching and destruction of habitat. Destruction of habitat was due to the construction of barrages and irrigation channels. Marco Polo sheep. Marco Polo sheep are mostly found in the Khunjrab National Park and nearby areas. Their numbers have been rapidly decreasing in the last 2 decades and WWF Pakistan has started projects for its conservation. Causes for population decline are hunting and loss of habitat. Hiwara bustard. This bird flies to Pakistan in winter season from former Soviet territory and settles in Cholistan and Thar deserts. The decline in its population is due to hunting by foreigners and destruction of its habitats. Marhor is the national animal of Pakistan and it is usually found on mountains. These have corkscrew-shaped horns which are up to 65 inches long in males and up to 10 inches in females. National bird of Pakistan is Chikar or Chakor partridge. It is a beautiful bird with light brown back, grey chest and buff belly. Its face is white with black border. This finishes today's lesson as well as the third chapter. A quick recap of what we have learned today. A species is called endangered when it is at risk of extinction in near future. In an ecosystem, a species is called extinct when there is no doubt that the last individual of that species has died in that ecosystem. During the last century, loss of biodiversity has been increasingly observed. In the modern era, due to human actions, species and ecosystems are threatened with destruction to an extent rarely seen in Earth history. Habitat loss is probably the greatest threat to biodiversity on Earth today. The destruction of significant area of forest has resulted in a degraded environment with reduced biodiversity. Overhunting has been a significant cause of the extinction of hundreds of species and the endangerment of many more. Pakistan also faces severe threats to its animal and plant species. The International Union for the Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, IUCN, and the World Wildlife Fund Pakistan are working in close coordination with Pakistan's Ministry of Environment and other government and non-government institutions for conserving biodiversity in Pakistan. So students, read these topics from the book as well, and it is very, very important that you learn these topics as well. So take good care of yourself. Thank you.